to the real ladies. It is time for some girl chat, my favorite time of the day. Let's get right into it. First up, Felicia Rashad, who played Claire Huxtable on The Cosby Show, which we absolutely all grew up loving, has spoken out again with her thoughts on the iconic show's legacy. In a new interview with Bustle, Felicia said she doesn't understand why anyone would be uncomfortable watching the show now as they once did before. Now, when she was pressed on the people online who said they won't watch anymore, obviously because of Bill Cosby's situation with him, sex assault conviction, she said that people on the internet are just anonymous voices and that she doesn't accept what someone says just because they say it loudly. So, ladies, can you understand why some people may be uncomfortable watching the show, why it's been pulled off of syndication, why it has not been playing on TV? Do you understand why they made that decision, and do you think that is a wrong decision and that people shouldn't have a problem watching the show?
I'll go first. I think first of all, The Cosby Show was an iconic show, right? I mean, millions of people love this family. I know I was one of them. Groundbreaking. I had never seen, you know, a family that both husband and wife were professionals on TV. They were shown in such a positive light. But how many women came out and, you know, had allegations against Bill Cosby, right? So my thing is, it's hard to separate the man from the show. You know, I think you can't watch the show and not go, I wonder what was happening then. I wonder what was happening now. I think it's hard to separate. But my heart goes out to the cast. And I'll tell you, as an actor,
yes,
when you're on a show that's such a big hit and it goes into syndication, yes, and then you get the residual checks, those residual checks could set them up for life. So for me, I really feel bad for the cast because they're not getting paid because the show is not being aired anywhere. And so that's where I feel the, in a way, the injustice is for them, is for the cast.
You know, if maybe if they would have had more than one black show at that time, we wouldn't have to deal with this. Because back in that time, it wasn't a lot of black shows. You had, like, you know, we had Fancy finally to come after that, you know, and we had a few black shows, but not like a lot of black shows that had an actual black father. So I think, one, right, I do think that she is too close to the situation, but there have been shows where people have done things and they're still running. I mean, Kramer on Seinfeld, he, you know, was known to sprout out a racial slurs when he was playing at a comedy club, and they're still playing Seinfeld. Now, I'm not comparing that with allegations of what Bill Cosby went through and he's been convicted of, but the thing that I would suggest is maybe run the show on certain stations, but take the residuals from Cosby and actually put it into a victim's fund to go towards the victims.
The thing is that we have to consider is that this is not a blanket conversation for everybody in the same way. We are talking about a man's guilty actions when it comes to abusing and misusing the trust of several women. So we have to think about the safety for victims out there. When it comes to watching things like this, this can be very triggering. For me, when I look at Cosby, I don't see it the same way. And yes, it's because of my past, but this is not a conversation to throw out there and think that everybody should have an opinion whether or not this show should stay on because of what it meant to you or how you saw it back then. So I think this is a personal decision and you have the right to not watch it. Am I out here campaigning to not have the Cosby Show on? No, but am I choosing in my own personal life to turn off programs that might remind me of women that have to be abused, women that get shunned for their voices, women that have to completely change their lives because even smells can trigger them. That's the women that I'm thinking about when it comes to The Cosby Show. And so I think that when we make a blanket statement about why the show should be on, we're not thinking about the reason why Cosby is now taken out of normal society standards. Does that make sense?
Absolutely. I could see it from both perspectives. I can absolutely see how even moving past a paycheck, Garcelle, a lot of these people felt that The Cosby Show was their legacy. It was what they were so proud of. It was they were proud of those groundbreaking moments, what they represented for the culture, for the African-American community, and what that meant to them. So even more than like, damn, I'm not getting my residual check, but he absolutely stripped them of their legacy as well. So I understand that perspective of how they could feel like, damn, this one person wrecked the whole show and everything that we worked so hard of and that we were so proud of. I get their perspective, and at the same time, if I was a victim of this man or a family member of a victim of this man, I'd be raising all kinds of hell. Like, they better not show this man on TV. He should never be celebrated or shown or portrayed in any positive light. And that is just the reality of being a human with feelings.
But the reality is, too, is that there are some people that feel that he is not guilty. That is also reality. I agree with what Jeannie is sort of saying, is that don't watch the show. If you don't watch the show, they'll take it off. Because if they're not going to make no money off of it, they'll take it off. Right. When they play R. Kelly, I turn it off.
I was just going to bring up R. Kelly. I was just going to bring up R. Kelly.
But if we're going to be honest, this is also about the point that this was one of the only, at that time, African-American shows on the air. So people have feelings about that. And it's just it's one of these messed up situations. I wish this would have never happened. But that's why we always ask for more diversity.
I agree. Guys, I want to bring up another topic. Tennis superstar Serena Williams is gracing the cover of November's British Vogue issue on newsstand right now. And I mean, you know, she looks amazing as always. But she spoke specifically about the impact technology has on bringing injustice to the Black community to light. Serena said a quote, "I have so many people who are saying, I'm sorry for everything you've had to go through. I think for a minute they started not to understand because I don't think you can understand, but they started to see." I was like, well, you didn't see any of this before. I've been talking about this my whole career. So I think the question is, she's saying the impact technology, because everybody can film on phones, it's brought a lot to light, and now people, white people are paying attention. So her question is, why didn't white people see this before technology came in? And so I'd like to know what you guys have to say. For me, I feel like white people were just going on with their lives. They were just going on with their lives. Maybe if they saw something, they didn't get it. And I feel like because of George Floyd, because of COVID, because of quarantine, people were sitting still, people were in their homes and had to watch what happened. This horrific thing that happened to George Floyd. I think that's what made, you know, people sort of now be more aware and more woke, if you will. What do you guys think about this?
I think for a long time, people thought that people of color were making up stories about racism and discrimination.
Yeah. Yep.
And you're right, you know, Garcelle, that people are in their own lives. They're busy with their own lives. They're busy raising their kids. You need to have some friends of color, especially some Black people.
Yeah.
And that's the thing, too. We're still a segregated country. We still don't have a lot of, we may work with people of color, but when we go home, do we have different people of different cultures and ethnicities? So I think that was a large problem. Yeah. But then also, you know, here it kind of goes back to what we were saying about having diversity on television. We also need to have diversity in news. If the national news doesn't cover this stuff, which they hadn't been covering, you know, people think that it doesn't exist. So thank goodness for technology. Thank goodness for videos now, because you see, wow, this really is happening. And there are some injustices that's happening. And now you get to see it. So now you have to, you know, as a person say, is this morally right? So this is just, it's thank goodness for technology, because now it's showing that, you know, people were saying there are things happening in our communities, but, you know, people were denying it. Now you can't deny it because it's right there on camera.
That's right. That's right.
And sadly, there are folks still denying it, even with the visual proof and watching it.
That's
I really think it depends on proximity. Sadly, if it doesn't affect you personally, most people just don't care. Because it doesn't affect, like, if we're being honest, we hear things in the news all the time about what's happening currently in Armenia, what's happening in Turkey with women, you know, and because it doesn't affect us personally, we don't get impassioned to bring awareness to the situation. Yeah. And that is sad. And that's why I love it when Jeannie says that what we need more in this world, in this country, in our homes, is empathy. To care about other people, even if it doesn't directly affect you. And I think what we are now seeing, obviously, in our allies, in white allies, is now that it's brought to their attention, they're like, damn, I want to be a part of the change. And for those people,
right.
I applaud you.
Right.
But at the same time, it is frustrating to be like, why weren't you always paying attention? Like, you kind of want to be like, that's what frustrates me. I'm like, how did you not notice? What bubble were you living in? And that's just how I personally feel. But if you are now stepping up to the plate and choosing to be an ally, thank you.
There's one step to truly lock in the power of empathy, Adrian, and I think that's acceptance. For anybody non-Black, I think you need to accept that you are ignorant to understanding what it's like to be Black. Straight up.
Yes.
If you are not Black, you have to
straight
own.
Okay to
you
say,
have to know.
I don't understand.
You have to own. I will never understand what it's like. And that's why these videos are making people just gasp and, you know, grab their pearls, because they're like, this is happening today? Because you will never understand coming out of your car, getting groceries late at night, you know, getting a job, buying a house. You will never understand. So first step, if you are not Black, is to accept I do not understand what it's like, the difficulties, the injustice, the racism.
And can we
that black
talk about
face.
It?
And so can we talk about it and then sit back and empathize and absorb what you hear and what you take the time to go learn? That's the step that Adrian's talking about, but I truly think first you have to accept, because people are still too comfortable to say, I have Black friends. I live in a Black neighborhood. I work in a Black company, whatever it is, thinking that then fills the quota. You will never understand. Even 30 years from now, even if I took a Black history class, I will never understand what it's like to be Black.
I don't want to just get
the
on
Black.
The
first step is understanding
I'm
that you will never
cultures.
Understand.
No, I'm
accepted.
Talking about all cultures. I'm not just talking about Black. I'm saying
of
that
course.
We have a problem in this country of segregation where even, I mean, we were talking about how, you know, we treat each other, how we were talking about in the Asian community, how they're being discriminated against because of the Chinese virus, you know, how kids are still in cages in the Latino community.
The
so it's not
Mexico.
Just, I'm saying that we need a way to
it's
make,
just
the reason why we have this show is to talk about diversity. This is not just a Black show.
Yeah, absolutely.
This is a diverse show. So we're going to try to start talking about stories that affect us as a country and even as a world.
I love that.
And bring on people to help us understand it. That's the reason why. It's not, you know, I just don't want to get all of us caught up on Black, because then it feels like it's just a fad. And then we forget about it.
Yes, but pertaining to this conversation with what Serena is speaking about. Yes, pertaining to this conversation.
Right.
I think that's where we were directing what our feelings are. But, Lonnie, you are right. In learning about this time, especially for 2020, it should involve us taking an active step to be responsible
and
to take care
of
one another
all
in this
us.
Community.
Right.
And all of us. Yes, absolutely.